I'm in a 2022 Nissan E-NV200 electric vehicle, and in this video I'm just going to talk about the battery cooler option in the settings that some vehicles have, because some people picked that up on one of my other recent videos and have asked about that. So this particular E-NV200 is a 2022 model, and it's got the 40 kilowatt hour battery, and this is the last of the E-NV200s. And it's an Acenta model, and actually it's got a different stereo to what the previous ones had. This has got DAB radio as well, and you can identify these ones because they've got this bit of plastic silver trim there. But anyway, that's not what this video is about. So up on the screen here, in a recent video that I did about the charging and preconditioning timers, the option for a battery cooler was there. So let's use these buttons and scroll through the screens, and we've got to go to settings there, then we can go down to detail, and there we've got battery cooler. So this is something that many E-NV200 owners wouldn't have seen before, particularly with the UK spec ones. But actually I don't think I've seen that option before, and I've had a few of these 40 kilowatt hour models in. It certainly wasn't on the 24 kilowatt hour models. But anyway, I looked in the user manual and it says where fitted. So maybe that's the issue. Maybe it was sort of optional on the earlier 40 kilowatt hours, and it's only because this is a later model, maybe they just put more options on them. But anyway, let's just show you what this does, because actually it's a little bit pointless, or a bit pointless having it in the menu anyway. So if we select it, all you can do is enable it or disable it. So what's the point of having it in a menu? Why would you ever want to disable the battery cooling? It's an automatic thing anyway. It kicks in when it's needed. Why the hell would you want to disable it? So I've had a look at the user manual and I've printed the two relevant sheets out here, and it says lithium ion battery cooler where fitted. It uses the air conditioning system to cool the battery, and it prevents the battery from overheating. And on these and the Nissan Leafs, you get a battery temperature gauge there, which I don't think any other EV has. And to be honest, it's probably pretty pointless, because a bit like temperature gauges in combustion engine vehicles, most people don't really know what it means or what it does. And that's why even on combustion engine vehicles, temperature gauges are pretty much gone, and you just have a red status light if there's an issue. But anyway, let's have a look at what the user manual says. And the battery cooler automatically turns on under the following conditions. The lithium ion battery temperature is high while quick charging, or 200 volt normal charging operation. The battery cooler automatically turns off when the battery temperature decreases. The battery cooler does not operate when the lithium ion battery is charged with 100 volt normal charging. So basically that's just saying whenever you're charging the vehicle, whether that's DC rapid charging or AC charging, if the battery gets too hot, the cooler will automatically come on, cool the battery, and then turn off. So why the hell would you want an option in the menu to turn it off? It also says that your charging status lights, which are the lights up there on the top of the dash you can see through the windscreen, they indicate a special pattern when the battery cooling is operating, and by the looks of it, it's the same pattern that it uses when the 12 volt battery is charging, and it's using the climate control timer. The lithium ion battery cooler performance is reduced if you're using the climate control while normal charging operates. So that basically says if you're running the air conditioning in the cab while the vehicle is charging, then it's going to reduce the battery cooling because it's struggling where to put the cool air. So you can't have cool air in the cabin and in the battery at 100% all the time. So it's going to do a bit of mixing, and therefore both systems are going to be a bit compromised. And then it says lithium ion battery requires more time to charge
when the lithium ion battery cooler operates. So basically that's saying if your battery is hot, the charging is going to be reduced even if the cooler is operating. And that's what happens anyway. When your batteries are either very hot or very cold, the charging speeds are affected. And then next, the lithium ion battery may not charge to the expected level using the charge timer when a start and end timer is set while the battery cooler operates. So that's just basically saying that because your charge times are affected, it may not charge to the expected level in that restricted charging period. So that makes sense. And then finally, the battery cooler uses a blower. Therefore, vibration sound might be felt, heard from the blower during the operation. So it's basically saying it's going to be using a fan and you're going to hear that. So there we go. That's about all I can say about the battery cooler because I haven't noticed it before. Maybe I've had other vehicles with it on and I've missed it. But maybe it's an option. And because this is a late one of 2022, the very last of these, because these have gone out of production now, maybe they just fitted all the options on the UK spec ones near the end of the production run. I'm not sure. Or is this a result of the charge gate issue? So on the Nissan Leaf and the Nissan E-NV200s, they had an issue that if you DC rapid charged them multiple times, the battery overheated. And if you were doing a very long distance journey where you had to do multiple DC rapid charges, which to be fair, not many people did in these sort of vehicles. But anyway, if you were doing that, after the second rapid charge, the battery would get too hot because you were doing high speed driving typically between those charges as well. And you had to let the battery cool down before the vehicle would charge up again. So because of that, were they then fitting the battery cooler as standard to these later models? And if you can add any information, do let me know in the comments below. And has anyone else in the UK got the battery cooler option in their E-NV200? And what year and model is it? So that'll do for this one. Very specific video, but anyway, someone might find it interesting. If you have, please do click the thumbs up as always. And if you want to know more about the Nissan E-NV200, down below will be a link to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made on these vans.